美しくデビルメイクライ。
タプコン。
Oh, hey, that's the wrong damn thing. Hold on a sec.
Everyone.
There we go. I have too many inputs to save my life. Alright. Hi. Hello, Author Blues chat. Hello, my chat.
My webcam's so dark and my hair's a mess.
Alright, there we go. Oh, hey, I forgot to put on captioning. There we go. Cool beans. Hey, last year we had a race.
Did we do this last year?
Yeah, we did. It's about this time too.
Oh.
Yeah.
I didn't realize it had been that long since we did it last.
Yeah, well, I haven't really touched this game. Probably the last time I played it was either with you or it might have been on Hotfix at some point. I don't remember anymore. I haven't touched this in a long time though.
I feel bad that I missed you doing this on Hotfix. I didn't realize you did.
I think if I did it on Hotfix, it was like February or March. I just don't remember anymore.
Hmm.
Yeah, let me just adjust the volume. This is way too loud for me.
How does this randomizer work? It randomizes specifically mainly the locations of the Koopas. Since for every level, that's really the deciding factor is finding the Koopas that have the items you need. So every single world, the Koopas have just been shuffled around.
Yeah, like
so there's no like correct route through any given world now.
Yeah, the other thing that the game has is like the randomizer has is it can actually like you can turn on easy mode, which if you hit start, it's not enabled for this ROM, but if you hit start, it'll show you where all the items are.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, I keep meaning to like change the questions in this. I haven't had any time to return to this project because I have a billion and seven other things to do. But one day I'll come back to this. I might rewrite the questions.
That'd be cool.
Yeah. Make them less colonial.
Then you could just, like, ask... Then you could ask just, questions about artifacts, but you could just ask, like, Mario questions.
Yeah, or you can, like, totally flip it on its head and, like, for all the cities that were colonized, just start writing questions about, like, who actually is from there.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. No, the Koopa locations aren't RNG in the original game. There's specific roads where the Koopas that have the items are actually located.
Yeah, actually, let me drop a link in the chat here if anyone's interested, because I actually routed it based off of someone else's world record run. And if you, like, have the generic, like, you don't have, like, the modified version that we're playing, this is how you play it really quickly, and there's even a map for each level. And the answers to the questions. My goal is not to look at the answers to the questions.
I will be looking at the answers to the questions. I do not think that that's necessarily going to guarantee my win.
It was pretty close last year. I think you were only a minute behind last time. Because, like, I did it in 54 minutes, and I seem to recall that you were just barely a minute over where I was.
Yeah, I think the thing about this is that if we both look at the questions, then we're going to be pretty damn close.
Yeah, it just comes down to, like, getting the three Koopas, and then,
The problem is if I don't look at the answers to the questions that I'm going to need to talk to people to figure out the actual answers because I won't remember them, and that's going to involve talking to cops, and I'm not doing that, so...
Yeah, boo. Maybe we don't want to talk to the cops. That was the other thing I keep putting off doing because I want to change the cops to, like, something else. But the way the sprites are compressed in this isn't like other Super Nintendo games I've come across, and I just can't be bothered to figure this out. One thing I'd rather do instead is rearrange the pipes. So that way, even though this map that you may have in front of you looks right, it will not be right if you actually use the randomizer.
Yeah.
So.
Alright, well I'm ready to search for Mario when you are.
Yeah, well, I can just count down and then just do... Hold on a sec, is my controller even working? Here we go, alright. You can just count down and I'll just hit go.
Alright, 3, 2, 1, go.
You gonna go or what? There we go. So I'm just gonna go random doors. Like, I don't even know what cities are in here anymore. Oh yeah, this is Beijing. I think there's an easier way to pull up the map. I think it's like select. No, you actually have to do it this way. What do we got here? Maybe if I'm lucky.
R is the button to pull up a small map.
Oh, right. It's been a long while since I played this silly game. Also, I think... How do you get... There's a way to get Yoshi in this?
Yeah, if you identify what location you're in.
Oh, right. Thank you. Jeez, it's been that long since I've answered this question. Or played this game, excuse me.
Is this one?
There we go. Because you, like, go, like, I think you're, like, three times as fast when you're as Yoshi.
Yeah. As soon as you said that, it reminded me that I should grab Yoshi.
Okay, I got one item already.
This one's not the San Francisco map. This is the other one?
Yeah, it's... The, this might be the controller. Oh, did I grab the wrong controller? Oh well, that's fine. We're gonna have to play the broken controller. The rubbers in the Super Nintendo controller are a precious commodity. You're doing 96 exit tonight, aren't you?
I am.
Oh, hey, Garby. Sorry, I didn't say hi to you, Garby. I didn't mean to forget you there. Oh, if you haven't seen this game before, you're in for a treat. This game is very educational in the sense that it is not. There's a mistake in the London level if you can spot it. I'm not speaking to the Rosser. I only have one item yet. Ah, okay, two items. What do we got here? This sucks. I actually have gotten most of the items, or killed most of the Yoshis. There's one left. That's one darn level. No, wait, where's the other one then? Have I grabbed all the items? No, where the hell's the other one? Oh, they're at the bottom. Where am I right now? if I take this pipe, it'll take me down there. Okay. Okay, so let's go down here. Which city are you in?
Rome.
Rome? That's a city I'd like to visit. Alright, why is...
Okay. How do you select the item that you're wanting to turn in?
Oh, you have to go... So this is the other problem with this here, is you have to select the item in the menu, highlight, and then go talk to the person. This one is... I want to return this.
How do you talk to them?
You click... I think you press A. Oh, and here's the other thing. So, like, there's actually an order to how the questions are answered. So, like... if you, like, deviate at all from the... from a correct answer, it'll change the order of the questions moving forward. So, like, if you're speedrunning this game normally, you have to, what's the answer to this? It's,
I can't figure out how to talk to the lady at the information booth.
So, you have to be underneath her, like, have Yoshi's nose under her, and then press A. Or, yeah, A. You can talk to anyone. You
oh
can talk...
my god.
Yeah. Yeah, it's not very intuitive. The other thing that makes this really ridiculous is if you press start when you're like, say you have the wrong item and you go talk to them and you go change the item, you can't. So like the item is like in your hand and it's stuck or something like that. How long is the Great Wall of China? It's like, oh, that's in miles. What the hell is it in miles? Sure. And, I don't know the answer to this. How many men did it take to build the Great Wall of China? Like... I don't know, 30,000? Okay, so if you answer the question wrong, then you have to, like, wait for Peach to not be angry at you anymore.
Yeah.
She's like, oh no, I don't care about my boyfriend, or whatever Mario's relationship to her in this game. Which is a big mood right there. Okay, that long. There we go, now I answered it, thank God. Where did I end up? Down at the bottom? Scherzes. Yoshi is a responsible horse in this game, though, by the way. Yoshi will not let you go down the middle of the street when, going between, like, the other streets. There you go, finally, I'm done in Beijing. I think I figured out that I've been to like a sizable portion of the cities in this, which is oh crap, why did I go this way?
Not the wrong way.
I decided to go through Africa to get to America.
This game doesn't let you stomp on cops.
I will remove oh that was a nice start there. Okay, sure, I'll take the item.
What if this game let you what if you could replace all the Koopas with top sprites, and then you could stomp on them for the items?
I could do that. I could
Those
do that.
Good ideas.
I could actually make something like that happen. Like, all I have to do is figure out the OAM slot for the Koopas, and then for the OAM slots for the cops, and then just swap them. That's easier than like trying to replace them outright. Okay, are there any cops down? Where are y'all on the street? Kinda wanna take the music from this game and put it into like into a Mario hack or something. Just have like super chill Mario or something like that. Luigi would call the cops.
I know some of it is like hyper stereotyped and stuff like that, but I do kind of like the pleasant like culturally appropriate attempts at like Mario remixes. Some of them are good, if not like kind of weird stereotypes.
I kind of agree. The only part where I really dislike the game's music is with South America, and just because like they all treat them as the same. Cool, I have all the artifacts. And I found that really jarring because like. I've been to South America, and the thing that just kind of like I don't know annoyed me was having done salsa dancing and become very familiar with the differences in the different types of salsa dancing, and then hearing this music and going like there is way more to this than that. Telegraph Hill. Cool. Alright, so we got that. And then there's a pyramid down this way. I'm in San Francisco, by the way.
Nice.
That's a nice city. Too bad it's expensive.
San Francisco, I like it.
I almost moved there.
Really?
Yeah. concrete base, and yeah, it was long story, but there was an opportunity for me to move there at one point. I didn't take it. It's probably for the better. You miss your country, though. I'd like to go back to it. What color is the orange? And then it connects to Marin County. Okay, cool. I'm not in San Francisco. Oh, so at the end of every level, you get, like, you get a password. It doesn't retain the seed value, hey? So if you reset the console and then do the password, you just end up with a default seed value.
Oh, interesting.
I don't know if it has any use, but, you know, like, if somebody were to, like, speedrun the game, I guess they maybe speed, like, reset their console and perhaps get a better time? I don't know. I'm in Moscow. Oh, hey, cool item. I will say that the most, like, banger music in this game is probably Moscow. It's another city I'd like to visit. I mean, not anytime soon, but, you know. Gameplay is a lot of fun. Like, it's an easy, chill game.
I feel like if you go into this earnestly trying to play it the way that the game wants you to play it, it's actually kind of a fun 2 or 3 hours.
Yeah, exactly. I don't know if you really would get, like, much of an education out of it, though, but, like...
No. I wouldn't consider it highly educational, but it's chill, it's answering trivia questions that the game contains answers to on the inside, so...
Yeah. Like, I'll put
a little bit of text and answer some trivia questions about it.
Yeah, I'll put it this way. I'll play this game again, rather than Mario's Time Machine. I really do not like Mario's Time Machine.
I do not like Mario's Time Machine either.
Like, I have the world record in the Windows Deluxe version, and you know what? I never want to play it again. I'm the only one who's played the deluxe version too, but so, like, I'm not gonna split hairs on that one. But the only reason why the Mario's Deluxe version, I bothered to play it was because of the horrible voice acting. And it is bad because it has that 90s racism that, you know, it was kind of acceptable then because no one really, like, thought that it was really a big deal. But then you look back at it now and you're just like, good lord, how the hell did we tolerate this? It's like,
I tried to hit down twice on a trivia question to pick the right answer and did not register both down presses, huh?
Oh no.
So I'm locked out of that one for a few minutes.
Biggest in the world? Cool. Alright, cool. And then there's one more down this way. Was it Ivan the Terrible that ordered the church built? Who the hell did the... Yes. But how tall is it? Okay, sure. 107 feet, sure. Whatever. Alright. There we go. Now I'm done. Moscow. Mario is missing. He is indeed missing. He is trapped somewhere in the Antarctic.
Too bad for him.
Oops. Alright, we're in Nairobi. Nairobi has like the least efficient route.
Well, they can't all be winners, Carrie.
That's true. I have way too high expectations for this game, I guess. I gotta like set the bar a little bit lower. You know what just occurred to me? The timer's not even showing up on. There you go. There we go. That's better. It's like you can't even see the timer. What a responsible horse. Mario is somewhere in, somewhere in Antarctica, you know? Well, how many cities are you in now? You're on the fourth one? Okay, so you're on par with me right now. God, there's like, all of them are at the bottom too. This sucks, okay. Did I go to one street? I gotta go to one street. They're all definitely down there. Make Mr. Freeze puns? Do you know what? As bad as that movie was, I still have to admit I enjoyed the hell out of the Batman movie with Mr. Freeze. Come on, you must be the last. You must be the item. Okay, maybe you're the item. There you go, you are the item, okay. If I take this pipe, that'll take me over there. Okay, good, here we go. No, you are the elephant, I think. It's also a preserve, and run free, cool. All right, we're done. Let's go down this way. What a silly game this game is.
Find those Koopas first.
You know, it's great. Luigi's just wandering around with a skull in his pockets. Oh my god, that's great. Sorry, what?
For once, it's not his own.
What was the last MCU movie I saw? It might have been Endgame. It's made out of small birds. Oh crap. Okay, well, that actually might fix my question order, so whatever.
The idea is that the artifacts have been stolen from their locations and you're returning them. But for some reason, they won't let you return the artifact unless you answer some trivia questions about it. Does that make sense?
So, do you know what Bowser's evil plan is for in this game?
I don't remember now.
He wants to, like, buy up the world's supply of hair dryers to melt the Antarctic.
That's right. It's a good plan.
Yeah, you know, it... I guess it works. I imagine, though, like, if you produce, like, that many, hair dryers, that you might, just, you know, increase global warming anyway. Here we go. Cool. Where are we going next? What city is this? This is probably Rome. If I remember right, the game reuses the same backdrop for Athens.
Yeah. and Rome are the same place?
Yeah, something to that effect.
Nice.
Do I want to go up or down? Eh, whatever. Alright, what do we got here? Okay, and then let's go this way. Oh, hey, there's a Koopa there I missed. Oh, there's two Koopas on this street, okay. I'd be only so lucky if I got all of them on that first try.
I've killed almost every Koopa in San Francisco and I haven't found a single artifact yet, this ends.
Wait, that shouldn't happen.
Well, no, I mean, I haven't killed all of them, I'm just saying...
Oh, okay.
Like, I've gone through meticulously and killed them in what I would consider a fairly efficient order, and it turns out that I went entirely in the wrong direction.
Hmm. I guess now that I know Java, I can actually read that person's code that goes through the entire RNG process. I don't know why I wouldn't want to subject myself to this, but, you know. Yes, actually, that's efficient. That's efficient. Alright. Which one are you? You're the Sistine Chapel, aren't you? Yeah, you are. Alright. Who painted the Sistine Chapel? Was it Michelangelo? Yeah, and then Sistine means six. Yeah. Yay for knowing a bit of Latin. Alright, so... Fountain, and to return around. There we go, we're good. Oh, you're slightly ahead of me. Gladiators would use this, and it was built in 8072. And I'm done with this city. Now for the boss.
Yep, just finished that.
Back here, you little prick. There we go, finish that boss. Great. My least favorite city in the world. Alright. Do you have an item? No, you don't. Let's say we go down. Walk along the Seine.
Have to have the small map open for the select button to pull up the city map.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't remember that at all. That's weird.
I was just sitting there hitting select over and over. I was like, why is it not pulling up the city map? And then when I pulled up the small map, the select button finally went. It's very strange.
So, I'm almost certain, like, the way that the game does polling and the, like, controller polling is, like, just borked. Like, I haven't bothered to spend any time figuring this out, because, like, I'm not going to invest that level of time, but it's just, like, there's little weird quirks in this game that really scream that this is not made by Nintendo. This is such a weird seed. Like, you have to wonder, when they were making this game, how they arrived at that particular value in the default game.
Yeah.
Because, like, I think it's, like, it starts with a 9 for one of the values. Like, there's two values. There's low and a high is how you refer... Oh! Well, this is not bad. Where the hell am I, though? Oh, okay, I'm on the perfect street. So, like, did they, like, go through multiple iterations of like, seeds before they went and, like, said, this is it? Engineer, cool. And then I want to go to the bell. Where the hell is it? Okay, I know where to go. The other problem with this game is, like, it has terrible clipping, so if you try to jump on the pipe, it'll just, like, throw you right off if you don't land on it just right. It'll be not a lady, and it's an example of Gothic architecture. Yoshi doesn't have a car horn. Yoshi has, Yoshi is a responsible steed that will not go and wander up the middle of the streets, even though there are no cars. It was built in 1836, and the Old Soldiers Association takes care of it, and I'm done City 6.
Nice.
We're winning. Nobody's winning, because we're playing Mario's Missing. But we're winning because we're having a good time.
Yeah.
Alright, where are we? This looks like Argentina. No, it's Rio de Janeiro. That's another city I'd like to visit. Hey, wait, is this not Rio de Janeiro? Oh no, it isn't. No, there's no bay, so this would be Buenos Aires. Right. What do you mean? Oh no, dummy! Wrong! I know where I am. I'm in neither. This is Mexico City. When you're in high school, you learn Spanish, right? Is that was the thing they do in the States, yeah.
Nope. It depends on your high school, like, what languages you're gonna have available to you. I had, French, Spanish, and Latin optional.
Oh, hell, Latin would have been fun.
Yeah, I wanted to take Latin.
If you learned French first, learning Latin is pretty easy to pick up. If you learn Spanish first, it doesn't really work as well. So French is generally compulsory in Canada until, like, you get into 10th grade.
Yeah.
But,
makes sense.
When I was in university, I decided to continue learning French because I was like, well, I need to get a language credit anyway. And the interesting thing that I picked up is that universities here won't teach you Quebecois, they'll teach you Parisian, or Metropolitan, excuse me.
Interesting.
Yeah, that was a bit of an eye-opener for me because there's a lot of words that aren't used in Quebecois that are used in and like Metropolitan French.
Right.
So naturally, I was a little bit, like, thrown off for a while until, like, I guess I got used to it. But then I stopped taking French in university and switched to Japanese. Because I was a weeb, so... did I miss it? I did. France first. So, like, when I speak... I've been to France...
This is a good seat for this level.
Which one are you in?
Sydney?
Sydney's a really terrible level to play in general.
I'm just gonna tell you right now, this was a very good one in this seat.
And yes, France French does suck, because if you learn Quebecois and you go and, speak Quebecois to, like, somebody in Paris, they're real snooty about it. To the point where, they'll tell you where to go.
Gotcha.
Yeah, there we go. Whereas the Belgians really didn't mind speaking French to me. It took 16 years and political. Alright, it's cool.
Yeah, in Sydney, like, the first three Koopas I stomped were all artifacts.
What the hell? That's wild.
Yeah. All right next to the blue pipe.
The revolution, and it faces, Juarez Avenue, I think. Yeah, there we go. There we go. I'm done with Mexico City. Right, where are we going next?
Oh, I thought that was really good.
This one is Sydney. Okay, I'm in Sydney now, so we'll find out if I get the same item placement. I don't think I will, because I did the cities in a different order from you.
Oh, okay. I didn't think about that being related to how it works. I have a fairly vague understanding of how the randomness works in this game.
There. Oh shit, I hate this. I hate Sydney's layout so much. Sydney's layout is just the worst.
Yeah, turning in all the artifacts was a little bit annoying.
It's like, for whatever reason, the city is like segmented off like really heavily. Up that way, so let's go up this way. Oh, stupid cop getting in the way. Alright, let's see what we got up here.
What are the odds, right?
Yeah, what are the odds that a police officer would get in my way? Alright, there we go. So Koopa here. Ah, there's an item. And then... Nope. It should be... I hope there's one on this street, because there's a question to be answered here. Damn it, there isn't. Let's go down this way. Nope, there's nothing this way. Do I have the surfboard? No, I do not. Just go down the middle of the street. No one's gonna hit a horse with their car. There we go. Go to select the surfboard. Want Manly Beach and the Air Championships. And then where's this one take me? I want to go up the street actually. And then zip along over this way. I'd like to visit Australia. That'd be a nice place to go to. Can only be found in Australia and be reached by ferry boats. Tempting to say kangaroo ride on that one, though. Resembles a sailboat, and it opened in 1973. There we go. That's Sydney. Where are we going to next? We are going to... This is Buenos Aires. There we go. Destroyed in that asteroid impact in, what was that movie, or book for that matter, Starship Troopers. What the hell? I just, like, launched myself into the air in this game. How did I do that?
You bounce on a Koopa and get, like, massive height?
I don't know what I did, actually. If somebody wants to clip that, I want to see what I did. It'd be really funny if you could just, like, launch yourself right into the air and then just, like, somehow wrap around or something. Where am I right now? Okay. There's lots of Koopas on this street. Holy crap, I got 2-for-1 on one of these hits. Nothing with an item, though. So I want to go down here. Go down this way, I guess. Twitch says you can't. I wonder if I set it to mods only. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to have that happen. Oh, there we go. There we go. Got all the items. Where the hell am I? I want to go down the street, I think. Yeah, I do want to go down here. Thank you very much for doing that for me. It's a cowboy, and they're made of, what, leather and stones? Perfect, okay. Yeah, I'm gonna have to look into that at some point, because that's actually really cool what happened there. It honors the founding of Buenos Aires, and you can get a... Probably this. Yeah, I don't think you can get a meal up there. It's pretty small. This way. And who performs at this? Jesus. Tango dancers? Yep. And, cool. Alright, I did it. Yes, American English is older than English. American English was standardized before the English standardized it. Like the Oxford Dictionary came out. I don't know who the standard is. For American English, is it Webster or something?
I think we would acknowledge any of them. I don't know if there's a standard for American English. I don't know the answer to that.
This is Greece. Okay, Okay, so I'm gonna have this. Greece is like one of the weirdest city layouts too. Or Athens, excuse me. Why am I calling it Greece? This pipe just takes me up there, so that's pointless. What I find interesting about these Koopas is that they explode.
Yeah. Kind of makes sense when Yoshi stomps on them.
If you, like, anything would, like, if you were, like, put enough, like, force on something when slamming down like that, sure, it might explode, but I have a hard time buying that Yoshi has that sort of mass.
No, they're just all packed full of explosives.
Oh, geez, what a horrible life that is. Actually, I think there's insects that actually, like, that do explode. Which insects are they, though? I'm trying to remember. Like, this is a red question. I'm certain they would know the answer to this. There we go. We got all the artifacts for this city. Let's get out this way. You gonna go down or what? Yeah, I want to say it's an ant as well, but like, I'm not the bug facts person. You are the carotid, which is this. And it has not been a disco, and the carotid's removed because of pollution. Okay. Because limestone will absorb pollution. And this is an example of Doric architecture, and it was built to honor Athena. Yes. Racking my brain to answer like these silly questions. And then they named the city after Hadrian. Yes. And then it's supposed to resemble the Arc de Triomphe. Okay, there we go. We did it. I have saved Athens from ruin. I'm going on to the last boss. Or sorry, the second last boss. Where are you at right now?
City number 12.
Ooh.
The second one of the next round.
You might actually beat me.
I don't like it. Apparently having answers to the questions has made a decided difference.
Well, I'm going into city one. Where are we at? London! London's a nice city. Have you done London already?
I don't think so.
Okay, you'll catch a spelling mistake.
Nice.
I don't want to be so lucky. Only be so lucky. What What I do like about the London map a bit is like how they go on about Shakespeare, and like I don't even think Shakespeare was from London. He was from like Stratfordshire or something like that. I'm forgetting the name.
Stratford-on-Avon.
The Stratford-on-Avon. Okay. And that's like what? Like northwest of London, I think. God, where are the other items? It's just a human being. I can't stomp on her. Please be the item. Okay, are you the item? Nope. There's an item here, I'm in business, but if not, then I have the bus anyway, I can answer a question while I'm here. It's his burial place, and yeah, there's the spelling mistake if anyone's looking for it. It's not this question here. About the year of Luigi, it was actually one of Nintendo's worst performing years financially, hey?
That makes sense.
Where is the other item? Can I take the tube there? Yes, I can. So then if I go down this way... screwing this up here, that's why I'm going the wrong way. Wait, where's the other item? No, I'm on the right street, okay. Nope, that's not it. You're probably it. Yep, you're it. God damn it, this game. Alright, well there, I have the answer. Where I need to go now.
It's always the least convenient Koopa to get to.
Oh, I know. Big Ben is a... actually, the bell. And it is 320 feet high. It's loud. Holy shit, is it ever loud. So, weird fact about that clock tower is that... in theory, you can hear the bell before you hear the bell.
Go on.
Okay, so this is how this works. So, I believe the BBC uses Big Ben, like, I don't know, at midnight or something like that, as a sound on TV, right? Right?
Mm-hmm.
So what they do is they will broadcast it on TV. But if you are in, like, a little bit across London, you will hear it on TV before you actually hear Big Ben.
Oh, nice.
Alright, which one is this map? This is Egypt. This is Cairo. I'm just on City 2. It sounds like you pulled way ahead of me.
I'm on City number 3 of the third set.
Oh, okay. That's still pretty much, you're like one city ahead of me. Go down this way. Are you like, I'll bet you like all of these items are just like in one single spot, knowing this game and how mean it can be. It's two. Where's the third item? Nope. Oh, you could be in worse places, I guess. Nope, you're not there. Okay, so there's not that many. Oh, please tell me one of them is it. Nope. Are you it?
Nope. What's up, Gilder?
Hey, Gilder. What a good guy that Gilder guy is. Alright, you better be one of those items. Yes, you are. Perfect. Alright, I don't know which one's which. You're probably the Sphinx. Sphinx is half man and half lion, I guess. And the Sphinx was given the name by the Greeks. And you are the pyramid. And they were built to be tombs. And it weighs 2.5 tons. Let's go return that clock. They traded an obelisk for the clock tower, and then it was the Sultan's crypt. What's being randomized with this? It's the item placement. That's one of the things that my randomizer does for this. Alright, now I'm going on to City 3. Oh, we're in Tokyo.
Predominantly, it's locations of the Koopas. The Koopas in the base game are more or less fixed. There's like, I think there is like some minor randomness to them based on the order of levels you do.
Mm-hmm. That's correct.
Good. Yes, please stop me when I say something wrong.
No, you're doing good.
But in this, it's just random across the board.
Yeah, we have no idea where the items really are, which is great, because this makes this game more enjoyable. Otherwise, if I played this, I would just use the default speedrunning path I have for this.
My Cairo is actually really good in this one, too. All of the items were in the bottom left corner, right near all of the information booths.
Damn. I think I lucked out on same way, like with Cairo. Where are the... Which one are you? Are you the lantern? Thank God I can do this one. It's in the... Asaku? Yes. And it's built in the shape of a pagoda. There we go. So let's go down this way. And then let's go down this way. The thing that makes this game a little bit challenging from a routing perspective is, like, do you collect all the items and then answer the questions, or do you collect the items and then answer the, collect the item and answer the question if it's, like, reasonably close? And that's the part that, like, makes the randomizer more difficult, because you could do that.
Yeah, both are totally viable options.
Yeah. I got all the items for Tokyo, finally.
I mean, I find I'm mostly focusing on getting the items first, but I will check all of the items I have against my inventory every time I pass an information booth.
Yeah, exactly.
But I'm not seeking out the appropriate information booth. Cool bug? Cool glitch?
Whoops. What did you do?
I landed on a... Okay, so there's like just a Koopa stuck to my Yoshi. I hope that doesn't come back to bite me. I
need to see this. Holy shit. Oh, is it gone now?
Nope, you can see it on my menu. On my,
Oh, app. What the hell? That is wild. I don't think it means anything. Like, I can't think of it.
I don't think it means anything either. I got into... You'd have to see when I jumped on him, because when I jumped on him, an actual Koopa was, like, stuck to me. For a second. I don't know.
Does changing streets fix it?
Nope.
Weird. Did I go the wrong way? Hi, I love you too. Where the hell am I? Oh, did I go like, I went like a really ass backwards way? Okay.
I'm currently just hopeful I don't, it's not like preventing me from getting an item I'm gonna need. Nope, I got all the items. So.
Yeah, I've never, that's a really wild, but hey, you gotta stop doing that, okay? I love you, but stop it. The cat wants attention, and she's, using her claws inappropriately.
I used to have a cat, and I would shut the door so that I could stream, and oh. She'd scratch underneath the door.
That's precisely why she's in here. I love her, though. Little terror of love and sharp claws. Alright. Where are all the damn Koopas in this here? I hate the Rio map so much. Yeah, I'd be only so lucky if that happened twice there. Alright, let's see what we get here. So lucky. Was that a cop up there or was that a Yoshi? Or a Koopa? No. Alright, I don't care about you. Alright, so we go down this way. And then... what do I have right now? I have a seashell. Is that... No, that puts me here. I don't have the seashell item yet. What's that?
Dot done.
You're done?
Yeah.
Holy shit. Congratulations.
Thanks, sub 1 hour.
I am on Rio still, so like I have at least one more city after this. Well, how's it feel that you've rescued Mario?
Good. I get to see the goofy Bowser faces.
The goofy Bowser faces, hey? Where is the other? Where are the other items? Where are the other Koopas? Oh, they're all the way over there. That's why. God, this game. All right, let's go over this way. Yeah, you definitely got like the better order than I did. That's for sure.
I went each city from right to left.
That was definitely a smarter idea than what I did, which was kind of like I'm just gonna go in random order.
I got a few really well laid out cities.
Oh, they're all in the same spot too. This game, holy crap. They're all in this like this one tight little corner that like you would never bother to go in a normal run. But that's okay, because once I answer this question, I can zip on up to the cable car and then answer that silly question. I wanna return, nope, it's wrong one, it's this one.
It's right, and she should say it. Yeah, she is a horse.
Yeah, I even have an emote for that. It is a trolley car and Guanabara Bay. There we go. Yeah, once I leave this level, I will demonstrate that Yoshi is a horse. Come on. Let's go down two streets, I think. It's down this street. Or if anyone who actually has my emotes can actually just go and spam in an aux chat. It's made from concrete. Imagine if it was made from, like, marble. That would be freaking expensive. Alright, there we go. I think you could just zip up this way. Horses can commit tax fraud. I love it.
That was fun. I like playing Mario's Missing every now and then. It's like, a kind of good game that I don't want to play very often.
Yeah. It was like one of those... The only reason why I started playing it was because I dared Amethyst to play it one day, and then you played it one night, and then I played it, and then I was just like... Hey, can I make this game not suck as much? Alright, I'm on New York City, so I'm doing the last city, finally. Alright. Let's go ride the, subway. Technically, you end up in New Jersey in this game, hey?
Do you end up in New Jersey?
Yeah, if you look at the map...
Yeah, I guess that's true. The map does kind of span the bay.
Yeah. Because, like, you end up in Newark in it. You go across to the other side. If I go this way, then I can grab this pipe here. Oh, come on. Here we go. The inputs in this game are so atrocious, though.
I only really ever notice how the controls are kind of just a little bit janky anytime I try to go down a pipe.
Yeah, because like you clip on the pipe, it might it'll slip off or whatever, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You press down and he'll like walk to the side to get off the pipe.
And like the game does auto pull, so like it doesn't do anything like silly like attempt to. One sec, do I not have Prometheus? No, I have King Kong. the game does auto pull, like it doesn't. Like read the interrupts directly. It just reads whatever the SNES puts inside a memory port. So like it's very strange how it has that issue.
Are you streaming more after this?
Yeah, I'm gonna do. I'm gonna see if I can de-rust a little bit of Shantae Half Genie Hero.
Oh, okay. Figured you just had another 8-hour Ace Attorney case to do.
Oh hell no! I'm not doing Ace Attorney until after HNEQ. Yeah, I am definitely not doing that game anytime soon.
Alright, well, I finished my seat and I don't have anything else I'm planning to do, so I'm sending everyone your way.
Oh, that's very nice of you. Well, hello to everyone who's coming over my way.
Don't tell Carrie.
Don't tell her. Don't tell Carrie what's happened. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, she'll... Don't tell her that we're raiding her.
Yeah, she'll be very confused. Well, this was a lot of fun. I'm almost done this.
Yeah, it was.
I'm gonna send the... What the hell is it? It's like French American.
I'll see y'all tonight. I'm gonna be doing a big New Year's Eve stream. I'm gonna do the 96 Exit Weekly. I'm trying to rope in a bunch of old people into doing it, so maybe it'll be a cast of familiar faces. And then after that, I'm gonna finish The Dig, which I believe if How Long to Beat is to be believed, I've only got a few more hours left of that, so I should be able to finish it tonight. And then other stuff. I don't know what other stuff entails, but we'll have a fun New Year's Eve stream. And then tomorrow, I'm doing Breath of the Wild All Shrines Race with Smartball, so that'll be an all-day stream.
The Dig is a good game.
Later.
Where is this here? There we go. Whoa, what is this? A raid from an authorblues? I have never heard of this streamer before.
Holy hecky.
Whoa, what the hell is this? Thanks for the, by the way, thanks for the, once again for the raid. That's gotten that very nice of you.
Of course.
I hope you had a good holiday. I know that, that this time of year is always a little stressful, but I hope you had a good a couple weeks off.
Yeah.
Well, I'm almost...
It's much more relaxing now, sitting at home playing video games before classes start better.
You start, what, in 2 weeks? A week? Something like that?
A week from this coming Monday, so a little more than a week and... Like a week and a half from now.
Oh, that makes sense. Yeah, absolutely. What does author blues even mean? Well, author indicates the creator of something. And blues is a form of music. All right, here we go. It's the old Manfred. You can actually get a double jump on this, hey? There we go. Yeah.
Oh, can you hit him twice on the way down?
Yeah.
I didn't know you could do that.
There we go. What was your time on it anyway?
A 58 something.
Oh yeah, so you had 7 minutes on me.
I also had the answers to the questions in front of me.
Oh, that's fair, yeah. This thing is, like, I don't even know, what I did is I went on, what was it? Like, I grabbed the answers to this, like, ages ago and just threw them in there. I probably could have made them nicer, a little bit more integrated into here, but something like that. But hey, it was only fair that you beat me this year. Last year it was me who beat you, so.
Yeah, other way around by probably about the same gap.
Yeah.
I think it was, like, by a whole level at least.
Yeah, exactly, exactly. Oh yeah, I also customized the credits in this game.
Mm-hmm. We were enjoying them in my stream.
Yeah. Sadly, one of the credits has passed away since.
Aww.
Yeah, the cat did. Aw, look at that. That was fun. We should make this a once a year, like the end of the year thing, if we ever want to make it a tradition.
Yeah, I'm done.
Yeah.
See you again next year.
Exactly. Cool, I'm gonna let these credits roll, and then I'm gonna set up the PlayStation 4 for Half Genie Hero, so, cool. Yeah, thanks a lot for hanging out with me, authorblues.
Yeah, I'll hop off the call, and I'm looking forward to watching the Half Genie Hero.
Awesome, well, I'll be about 5 minutes, but you take it easy, and good luck tonight, and Happy New Year to everyone.
Bye.
Alright, so I'll be right back, I'll put the commercials on, and then, yeah. And if you want to stick around, by all means, give me a follow, whatever. If you don't want to follow me, that's totally okay. Usually stream a couple times a week, so try and stream a couple times a week at least. But yeah, in any event, Daphne. Daphne was a really good cat. I miss her. All right, I'm going to put commercials on. I'll be about 5 minutes, and then we'll do some Half Genie Hero.